honor to where honor is. You want to give honor to the great pastor of this church, Pastor Dallas.
Yeah.
And we are here to help.
Yeah.
We are here to impart.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And I want to give honor to every minister on the roster. To the pastor here, to the minister on the keyboard, and to all of you, all my brothers and sisters in Christ in your respective places.
Amen.
Somebody said that, I think it was my mentor that said, I didn't know what God had called me to do when I first met her.
Yes.
But I want you to know I'm secure in it now.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord God. And it doesn't make any difference who accepts me or who don't.
All right.
As long as I'm accepted by God, I think somebody said that. I want to let you know I've been with God.
Alright.
And I got a word.
Yeah.
I've been with God and I got a word. And so there's no mistaking that you're here today. And I thank you. You sat so patiently through everything. And so that meant that you were meant to be here.
Amen.
Pastor Sellers, I heard you say that you've been 16 years in ministry, pastor.
Well,
want you to know 16 years a lifespan for somebody. It's a long time. It could be a long time, but I want you to know the Holy Spirit said you just got started.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You just brought it down, Pastor. You ain't really got started yet. Thank you, Jesus. So this right here diagnosed that God is beginning a new thing with you. And I think I told you a while ago that God, you know, the husband man, you know that scripture. And he goes into the garden and the plants are there.
Yes, right.
And he looks at the ones that's producing fruit.
Uh-huh.
They do.
Uh-huh.
And if you're producing some fruit,
uh-huh,
he looks at you with that proud father look.
Uh-huh.
And he knows your potential.
Yeah. Yeah.
So if you're able to produce some fruit,
yeah,
then you're able to produce some more fruit.
All right,
this must be just a little bit too loud. Because I really don't need a whole lot.
So if you're able to produce some fruit, some little fruit,
you're able to produce some more fruit.
That's right.
And the Father knows that about
us. Yes.
So you producing fruit and you think you're doing all right, and the Father comes over to your branch and he pulls some deadness off of you.
Yeah. That don't feel good. That don't feel good. That's what grandmama used to say. That's pruning. Uh-huh. That's pruning you. So he know your potential. And see, what we do is we always associate hurt with the devil.
All right.
Yeah, yeah.
This is a revelation here now. We always associate what don't feel good with the devil. My God!
All right.
Yeah.
But God knows your potential.
Yeah. Yeah.
My God!
Yes.
Job said, should I always receive good from his hand?
Yeah.
Should he always be handing me something good? It's like a spoiled child. If you don't get me right, if you don't discipline me, if you don't chastise me, I ain't gonna be no good. Be no good. I'm just gonna be a little old small child running around feeling like I can do whatever it is I'm big enough to do.
Yeah, yeah.
Get myself in trouble, then run it back to Father to get me out. Get me out. That's what some of our prayers about. God, get me out.
Yeah, yeah.
Now this ain't even my message, but God talking to somebody.
All right.
The Lord said the message for this house was a message of love and restoration.
All right.
I want you to know when God is chastising us, somebody said it in here tonight, that means he loves us.
That's right.
My God. The word of God can back me up and says that when you refuse chastisement,
uh-huh,
you are a bastard.
That's right.
So you don't have a daddy.
All right.
if you refuse chastisement from the Father. So it's not his will for us to run back and forth. Run back and forth into the same situation. He wants us delivered.
That's right.
That's what he wants. He wants us delivered. Now my text, y'all can find it. It's found in St. John chapter 5. It's talking about Jesus making a trip to the pool. The pool of Bethesda. That pool that had them five porches. And them people was laying around there. Say the lame, the sick. Those that were halted. And I went in, you know, the Bible dictionary and online looking at trying to get the definition of halted. Or halt. And the simple definition for that is that they were stopped.
Yes.
Here your life is just held up. Your life is just held up.
All right.
You can't go forward and you can't go back. Now the space between the man and getting to the pool, Jesus came. Y'all know the story.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Come on now.
He said he looked at the man and his situation here. What's going on? That's the way he's looking at some of our lives.
Yeah.
Hey, what's really going on?
Yeah.
Because you got everything you need.
Yeah.
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 That's right.
I don't understand.
Everything.
So I got to ask him, do you want to be whole?
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
You keep on running back. And then the space between him where he was sitting at and the pool was just excuses.
Yeah.
That's all it was.
Yes.
It was some excuses.
Yes.
Did you hear what he told her? I can't get there. Won't nobody help me? When I try to get there, somebody step in before me. Excuses.
Oof.
Come on now. My God. But I'm here to tell you tonight, the word of God said, oh man, you ain't excusable no more.
Oh my Lord.
Jesus didn't come on the scene.
Amen.
He has come on the scene. So your excuse, you can throw that away.
Yes. Preach, preach.
Someone said, well, I don't believe that. I don't believe that. I'm still under the law. The Bible said those that under the law, going to do it under the law.
Right.
You're going to be condemned under the law. So if they do it under grace, you're going to be condemned under grace.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's
so God is speaking expressly. He wants to restore.
Yes.
He wants to make you whole.
That's right.
He want to bring you out for real.
Uh-huh.
He don't want you to rely on these excuses no more.
Yeah.
They're just keeping you halt.
Yeah.
You stuck.
Yeah.
And you can't come out.
Uh-huh.
Because you're there in your mind. Your mind has got you stuck. People have got you stuck. Lack has got you stuck.
Oh, preach, girl.
Yeah.
My Lord.
Your past has got you stuck.
Uh-huh.
And I'm Jesus today said, do you wanna? Nothing stopping. Jesus brought that situation down so quickly. Because he's standing and said, what? Do you wanna be made whole? You mean from here to there? This is 38 years.
Jesus.
From here to there. All 38 right. years.
Ooh.
Do y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
How long have you been in your situation? How long?
Woo, preach, preach.
You gonna stay there.
Yeah.
My Lord. Making them same excuses. From here to there.
Oh my Lord.
38 years.
Come on, sister.
Make it plain.
Jesus is the bridge that will take you over.
That's right.
Yes,
he's the bridge.
Yes, he will.
All he wants.